So normally, guys, at this point, we do have a little chat around club news. But without Michael being here, it might be a little difficult. I think, Malcolm, what I was going to suggest was just remind people that this is the time of year for renewing their subscriptions if they haven't already. I don't know if we're aware of any progress on the next sepia release at all, Malcolm, for first
Yes,
part of this year.
it's pretty advanced. When it'll be, I don't know, but he's done most of the work, and it's maybe in CP's hands by now. I don't know.
Okay, so hopefully something to look forward to. I'm always looking on Spotify for any new BCE releases, or likewise on YouTube for any new BCE videos. But again, since the Christmas meeting, I haven't really seen anything new. Okay, so the next thing on our agenda for tonight is really Malcolm providing some video messages that he made on his tours. So Malcolm, I've still got the audio and video files if you want me to show them, or if you want me to just give you the ability to, if I give you the ability to share
Well, you're
your.
far more proficient than I am, so I'll just do the
Doesn't say a
introduction.
lot for you,
No,
but.
quite. So I'll do the introduction, and if you could play the first one, then let's have a break
Sure.
while I talk then. Anyway, over the years, as I've travelled the world, anywhere I met a Crosby person, I'd interview them, write something for the magazine probably, and if I thought it would be of interest to the Leeds meeting, I'd get them to send a little message. And I had some interesting ones. The first one I really did was with Phillip Crosby in 1999. There'd been recently a bit of a documentary about being, and Phillip stood up for his dad and ridiculed Gary's book, etc. So I made contact with him, and it was agreed we'd meet because we were going to go through Los Angeles. A man who used to write for Bing Gang magazine, Charles Bailey, who used to do the reviews of the CDs, etc. He invited us to stay with him for a day or two. And we invited Philip to come and join us. We had a nice chat in the garden. We went off for a meal, and I interrogated Philip for hours, you know. And he was so supportive of his dad and gave me so many supporting stories of how great his father was. I said, you really ought to let the press know about these things. So he did. A month or two later, he did a press release to say Gary was a no good liar, etc. My dad was wonderful type stuff. Anyway, I said, do you mind if I do a little video of you for Leeds? So you're now going to see that. Over to you,
Oh,
Jason.
okay, thanks, Mal.
I think I'd have been quicker than you, Jason.
Think you're right.
We're in Charles Bailey's garden. Phil?
And I can see by the red light we are rolling. It's very nice to be here in Charlie's garden, and nice to be able to address you and talk to you.
We're in
Although
Arcadia,
it's a little bit
California.
difficult, I don't now that Charlie and Malcolm have mentioned, but I had a great deal of dental work done, and I sort of talk like Sylvester Puddicat or Daffy Duck. But anyway, I hope you're having a great time over there. I wish I could be with you, and I know one day I will. I've been saying that for 15 years, but I'm going to get over there as soon as I get organized. People say I'm saying that all the time.
Okay, well,
You never
thanks,
know.
Phil.
Would
Thanks
that
very
be a
much
bummer?
for your contribution to that recent television program. Great that you came and said some good things there. We're very grateful.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure to meet all of you and to meet all you folks.
Thanks, Phil. So who's this with you, Phil?
This is my daughter, Dixie Lee, and she we very fondly call her Dixie Lee too, because as maybe most of you may know that Dixie Lee one was my mother. And I always said that my mom had a better voice than dad. Now, before everybody goes into the job, they just were both great singers. But I thought Dixie Lee was going to be, make it possible for me to retire around 25. Because as a little girl, she'd get out and do Sophie Tucker, you know, some of these days, and in school and sing all the time. She was just talking about her own daughter doing the same thing. But she got to be around, a little bit short of high school, and the inhibitions set in. I still tried to get her on the stage many times. I had that whole setup in Atlanta. I had the band. It was 4 o'clock in the morning. Nobody there but her friends. 5 stars she took it out 5 times. Then we get in the car driving home, and she sings the entire 3,000 miles from Atlanta to L.A. I got to listen to stuff by Diane.
Only in the car. Okay, thanks ever so much.
Like Linda Ronstadt. She could sing Linda Ronstadt and Barbara Streisand. Came away, David. Good night, folks. We're a little late.
Here's Charles and Nancy Bailey, our hosts. Charles, say a few words to the Leeds meeting.
Well, we had a fine time with Malcolm and Pat on this trip. Got an opportunity to meet Phil Crosby and his daughter, Dixie Lee. And here are some interesting comments from Phil. He's the one son that really supported his dad and still does. But says that Gary didn't know what he was talking about. He was just trying to write a book that would give him a little income. And Phil says he really wasn't too successful on that, which is fine.
Yeah.
But it's nice to have one of the sons speak favorably of Bing.
Yeah. Thanks, Charlie.
Okay.
Yeah. Nancy, what about your comments? Are you a Crosby fan?
Oh, of course. I can't say anything else, can I?
Well, thanks very much for the hospitality.
We really enjoyed your visit. I'm glad you came to California and visit with us.
Thanks ever so much.
Cool. Thanks, Matt, Malcolm. So, also, I guess Phil didn't get to the UK again after that. No,
he didn't. He died of that 5 years later, actually. He was 65 when I did that interview. And he just died. I talked to him about... I emailed him before Gonzaga and Hofstra, but he wasn't well enough to go. So he had to chicken out. In fact, at Gonzaga, it was Frank Sinatra Jr. who went. And so I emailed Phil, come on, Phil, Frank Sinatra Jr.'s good. But he wasn't well enough, so he had to pull out. And he, as I say, he died shortly afterwards, which was sad.
He's an incredibly nice guy, didn't he, as well? He seemed very, very, very friendly and natural.
Yes, he was. He had 5 wives, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, he was good company. You know, kind of man you enjoy spending time with, you know. He was very...
So, Malcolm, I found a clip from the Hollywood Palace with... singing with his dad. Do you want me to show that?
Yes, that'd be good, because it's a nice one.
Yeah, okay. I'll try.
By the way, there's something I've been meaning to talk to you about, and I don't know whether to mention on the air or not.
Oh, well, go ahead. I'm glad you came to me instead of dear Abby. What is it?
You know, you made a lot
of... I handle all these things.
Do you take care of that light action? You made a lot of hit recordings with Gary.
Gary and I, quite a few records. Yeah, we did.
I came up empty. You never made anything with me. Why is that?
Well, if I'd have recorded with all of you, Phil, you know, we'd still be there. They'd have run out of wax.
That's true.
I don't know how we could have done it. I did suggest it once, but the RCA dog bit me in the leg.
He got you.
Bang, he nailed me. I tell you what we could do, though, to sort of make up for you, to atone for the omission. We could do some of the songs you and I, that Gary and I recorded. And maybe the folks that like them will put them on wax. They'll sell a little Safeway in some of the supermarkets. Pick up a little walking around money. Would you go that?
Dad, you're a prince.
Oh, don't say that. That's how the RCA dog bit me in the leg. I said, here, prince. Oh, here's a happy tune. You love to croon. They call it sound. As can be the melody, they call it Sam's song. Nothing on your mind, and then you find you're singing Sam's song. Why
it makes you grin.
Yeah,
gets under your skin, as only a song can do.
Yes, people let you meet.
Hello, Joe, what you know? And remind me to motel, and business is slow, but I'm whistling Samson.
Everyone you see
has a story to tell or a gimmick to sell, but agree that it's all really swell. It's a grand song.
You made it. Good boy.
So forget your troubles and wear a smile. You'll find you'll never go wrong. If you want to croon like a lark in the park who is making his mark, serenading the dark with a chorus of Samson.
Oh, my right.
You simply take a favorite
day
and then you flavor
to the hill.
The scene down low, and then you jazz a little obligato.
Yes, the crick,
now that maggot,
and the creaking
old
mill.
No attention to the maggot play, but just rouse
too long.
Your blues
long
away
ago.
On the spot start to swing.
Yeah. Getting hot now.
The green
grove
is gone.
It's a joke and two
from the hill.
All around I see harmony charming me.
Where once
every love and note
the days sprung.
It's just the music that you can't
refuse.
I love
now you, know the
you
way.
The same
well, that band of
as of old.
And when you listen just
back
say I can
when you know. When you and I were young, Maggie Blue.
Here we go now. Musical demons that you honey to dream. And won't you play me some rags? And keep that classical nag to some sweet, beautiful rag. If you will play one from a copy of the
good old choppy,
you'll get all my applause.
Day.
And that is simply
day.
Because
yes, simple
I love to listen to rags.
You're such a groupie, Malcolm.
That was amazing.
A good bloke, Phil. He was. Another member of the Crosby family I met some years later was Nathaniel Crosby. We were in Florida, and through a contact, I managed to track him down. He very kindly agreed to see me. We had a very good chat. And at the end, I said, can I do a bit of a video? Would you set up for our Leeds meeting? And he said, yeah, fine. And if Jason can press the right buttons, we'll see it.
I know all the right buttons to press, Malcolm, but not necessarily in the right order.
Eric Malcolm himself.
This is Nathaniel Crosby. I'm at his lovely home in Florida. Nathaniel, last time I saw you live was on the stage of the Palladium in 1976, and you were singing Row, Row, Row Your Boat. Can you remember much about that?
A little bit. It was a nice little skit. Dad and I did a monologue for 3 or 4 minutes, and I started this punchline that when it was my turn to sing Row, Row, Row Your Boat, I went to my dad and say, step aside. So the band and the orchestra just fell apart. Jay Cannon was the drummer and he exploded. But every night I did a different routine about how I was going to tell my dad to step aside.
That was a great sketch, that was. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Those Palladium concerts were eye-opening to me. They really were. I mean, I'd been a Bing fan all my life, but to go and see him live was absolutely fantastic.
Well, from growing up in my generation, when we had Jimi Hendrix and Janis Joplin and Carole King and Carly Simon, I didn't really appreciate my dad's music and I hadn't listened to it. And the Palladium experience and the live shows that we did at the Euro Theater in New York and a couple of other concerts in different cities gave me the great appreciation and exposure to my dad's music for the first time.
Well, that's absolutely great. I'm going to show this at the Leeds meeting, and people in Leeds, of course, will love to know how you see the future for the Bing Crosby franchise. We're anxious to keep Bing's name alive. Does the family have any plans, or how do you see things going?
Well, it's a quick question. I would say that Christmas, fortunately, we get reminded of Dad each and every year. For whatever reason, the new versions of the old songs are not performed in quite the classic manner that Dad performed them. And we hear Dad each and every Christmas for a couple of weeks. And fortunately, instead of three network stations and a cable affiliate, we now have hundreds of television stations. So The Road to Hong Kong was just on Cinemax this past week, and I saw it for the first time.
Did you?
But basically, I think the Crosby family, or one of the Crosby family members, needs to attract capital to re-promote Dad's legacy and make it an entrepreneurial enterprise to really get it going. There are a few entrepreneurial efforts that are out there, individual efforts, which keep Dad's albums getting turned over into new product and new assortments of his old collections of music. And, you know, the major studios churn them out from time to time and do compilation albums.
Yes.
But, you know, hopefully we can get the studios in line and to be our friends and not our foes, so that they start promoting Dad's old music aggressively again.
Yeah. Well, thanks ever so much for that, Nathaniel. Thanks for your time today. The people in Leeds will be fascinated to see you in the flesh again. Thanks for your time.
I used to play in the York Turner, the tournament at the Benson and Hedges every year, the European Tour. So I think I played three tournaments there and missed the cut every year.
Oh well. Yeah. Thanks again.
All right. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for that, Malcolm. I must admit, when I heard that, and I didn't know how things were and how things turned out, just listening to Nathaniel now, I wouldn't have had much confidence for, you know, things getting any better around promoting Bing's work. But of course, things are much, much different now. And thanks to the family stepping up, although I guess Mary Frances probably is the face of BCE as far as we're concerned now.
Well, I don't know. I mean, Harry Crosby has probably been involved in the financial side because he's an investment banker. He's probably got the contacts to attract people like Primary Wave and $50 million, which are certainly doing the best to promote.
I get that, and I think you're totally right because he's behind the scenes. But when I said the face of BCE now, it's Francis who's out there been doing the Sky interviews and things in recent years.
How's Catherine? Do we know?
We don't know. I mean, she was 90 in November. Somebody who is in contact with her, well, is usually in contact with her, hasn't been able to track her down in recent times. So whether she's away with one of her children or whether she's ill, we don't know. We just don't know. So
fingers crossed.
Yeah, exactly right. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so Malcolm, we were talking about books before. I think I'd like to, you know, take a little time here to recommend Nathaniel's book, 18 Holes with Bing. It's a really interesting book. I wrote about it for the magazine a long time ago, and I remember really enjoying it many years ago when it came out. And, you know, it talks about Bing, talks about golf. So there it is. Jason has it. And it's a good book. I remember really enjoying it. And, you know, I recommend it to everybody out there.
Yeah, I agree absolutely.
It's very different, isn't it, from a lot of the other books, insofar as that it's based so much around the sport element, isn't it? And it opened my eyes an awful lot about the administration and financial and corporate and advertising side of the tournaments and things associated with Bing. I never realized they were so complicated and occasionally fractious, but
I think it puts into perspective really well, you know, how important Bing Crosby was in the development and popularity of golf throughout the 20th century. And, you know, with Nathaniel being a dedicated golfer, I think he is the right voice to talk about that.
Definitely. Certainly put it into perspective. And just very quickly, just to say, how Phillip was and how Nathaniel are, they just both seem obviously
very nice.
Really, really nice, extremely polite, affable guys. And whatever's said about, as we know, has been said in the past about being a parent, obviously something's been done right here, because they just seem such lovely, decent, nice guys. I mean, I wouldn't obviously can't with Phillip now, but I wouldn't object to having either of them around my dinner table. I mean, they just seem lovely.
Yeah, I agree. Absolutely right. Yeah.
One thing I found interesting in that interview was what we were saying earlier, Frank, regarding, being forgotten at Paramount or what have you. And we were saying about how, you know, the with each generation, they have their own idols and their own music. And straight away, there was Bing's own son saying he didn't know about dad's music until he was at the Palladium at the end of Bing's life, you know. So, kind of an answer there, yeah. So talking of that, Malcolm, you did share with me the clip from the Palladium. Shall I just play up to the part where...
Whatever.
Sorry?
Whatever suits you and your timing.
Cool, okay. Bear with me then, guys.
What was this? Where'd you come from?
Hey, that was really pretty good, Dad.
You like that little number? I thought it was spirited.
Well, not bad for 9 handicap.
Nine handicap? That's off the ladies' tees you're talking about. Now, what do you mean?
Now, what do you have for me to do?
I have a number for you, Nathaniel, that's absolutely going to cool your soul.
No, Dad.
Yes, sir. This is going to make... No, Dad. This is going to make you stand out, man.
Oh, watch out.
Well, it's going to be a round. You're going to sing a round.
A round?
Yes, sir.
Well, now, what's a round?
Round, well, you sing, you start a song, then we come in at different times, we all finish together, and it's a tremendous smash hit.
You ain't put me on?
No,
man.
No, like row, row, row your boat.
Row, row, row your boat?
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
What's the matter?
Well, that's for kids.
No, no. You'll think it's for kids. It's very tricky, and you have to be on your toes. You think you can handle it?
Step aside.
Step
aside. Listen to this.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
Continue.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream.
Row your boat
merrily down the stream.
What happened?
What happened?
What happened? What? Listen, don't listen to me. You just keep singing, row, row, row your boat. That don't let anything deter you. Go again, Pete.
Row, row, row your boat row, gently row, down the stream.
Row your boat
merrily down the
stream. You goofed again. Well, that put your fingers in your ear. See if that'll work.
All right.
Block me up.
I dig it.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream.
Row your boat gently.
Oh, Jesus.
What happened? You goofed again.
Let me try moving a little further away.
Get away. Yeah, go out there on Regent Street. Go out on Regent Street someplace. Get out down around Piccadilly. Let me hear from you. Can you still hear me? Can you hear me?
Oh, no.
Good. Now go ahead.
Row, row, row your boat.
Row, row,
down the
row your boat.
Merrily down the path.
Oh, he's gone again.
Oh, he did it again.
Harry, this kid needs a little help.
Wrong, Dad. I think he needs a lot of help.
Well, what are we going to
do? Mom, my friend.
Oh, I think you get the gist from that. I don't know, Malcolm, I know you were at the Palladium show in 76, how different it was on the night from that particular...
Oh, it was tremendous. Really entertaining. It was great.
Good stuff. Cool. Okay, well, thanks so much for that, Malcolm. What I was going to say as well is, I know on your global tours, you met so many people in the research for your books, so... Hopefully there's something else you've got to share in future meetings, if that's okay.
Well, I've got, some great stuff. And Michael Feinstein interviewed Ray Charles, not the black singer, but the one who was with Perry Como for many years. very good interview with him. He was when he left Perry Como, he produced some of Bing's shows. For instance, that one he did with the Supremes. Ray Charles was the man who produced that.
And directed. Oh, right. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, cool.
He's very impressive. Yeah. And I've got some lovely footage from our Australian members when I went to visit them. So I could keep you busy for hours, but I don't want to overdo
it. It'll be great, especially
wonderful.
Up to you, Jason.
It'd be great because we can see it's all really good fun and reminiscences, and it's great to see those interviews. So thanks again for that, Malcolm. Okay, moving on, guys. So we try wherever we can to have a little bit of a section of Bing in the 30s, the wonderful Bing voice. I've put together a few clips from a film that's somewhat neglected from the 30s, albeit towards the end of the 30s, and that's the reason behind this was, you remember we had the songs from Anything Goes a few meetings back. So here we put together the songs from Paris Honeymoon from 1939. So I hope you enjoy these.
On the prairie all the day, singing Lady Ole.
Yoo-hoo.
And the funny old hill sing back and say, Lady Ole, Lady Ole, Lady Ole, Lady. From far away. Got no gal, I got no pal, keep me company. Only got those funny old hills singing along with me. I'm happy, and it's there I long to stay, singing Lady Ole.
Ole, partner.
And then the funny old hill sing back and say, Lady Ole, Lady Ole, Lady Ole, Lady.
Good boy.
From far away. I'm happy on the prairie all the day, singing Lady Ole. And then the funny old hill sing back and say, Lady old, lady old, lady old, lady, from far away. I got no gal, I got no pal, keep me company. I'm happy, and it's far along to stay, singing Lady Ole. And then the funny old hill sing back and say,
the old hill's in a new hunk echo from far away, from far away, from far away. Nice going.
Ooh. 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 I ain't got nobody, and nobody cares about me. I ain't got nobody, and nobody cares about me.
I've got terrific news. Can you hear me?
Yes, darling. What is it?
The divorce comes up tomorrow. With any luck at all, I'll be with you in a week.
Oh, that's marvelous. Swell. Oh, say, wait till you see the judge is going to marry us. He's got a wedding gown with more gingerbread on it than yours.
Oh, say, did mine get there yet?
Uh-huh. Came this morning.
Fine. Tell me, how are all those roses?
Well, they'll still be in bloom for the honeymoon.
Mm-hmm. Hear that? My heart. It's humming. How about a little hum from yours? Pretty. Your heart's been taking lessons.
I have eyes to see with, but they see only you. Or you have eyes that put the very stars to shame. I have lips to sigh with. What else am I to do? When you have lips that fill my very soul with flame. Tonight, you're near to me. In a light bright as day, but you're so dear to me, I can see you even miles away. I have eyes to see with, and yet when we're apart, I close my eyes and see with my heart.
I have eyes to see with, but they see only you. For you have eyes that put the very stars to shame. I have lived to sigh with, what I to do when you have a lips that fill my very soul with flame.
Tonight you're near to me in a light bright as day, but you're so dear to me, I can see you even miles away.
have eyes to see with. And yet when we're apart, I close my eyes and see with my heart.
Close my eyes and see with my heart.
You're a sweet little headache, but you are lots of fun. Maybe I ought to thank you, then thank you for all you've done. You're a sweet little headache, and if you keep on that way, what a sweet little heartache you'll turn out to be someday.
Here, here, hey, hey, look out! Look on me! Look out! You want? Look out! You're broken! Hey, hey!
There's that melody straight from Romany, where it jubilates like a jubilee. But
jubilee.
I'm with you tonight,
finding new delight
in the magic of a gypsy melody. That rhythm in my heart.
And you.
And you and I. With the moon above.
Can't we fall in love?
To the music of a gypsy jubilee.
Cool. I hope you enjoyed that. I ever saw that film once on TV. It was in 1983. I remember it well, and recorded it on VHS at the time. I don't know what happened to Shirley Ross, though. I guess she's still in the bath. But it's good to see any of the films and music from Bing's films from the 30s, I hope.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, we're almost at the end. I've got one more short medley to play. Mentioned at the start of the meeting tonight how terrible the weather had been in the UK for the past 40 days and 40 nights, raining, right up until yesterday, in fact, when it finally stopped. And so I'd already had in my library a little medley of rain-themed songs of Bing's. And it came about because I love the films of Woody Allen, and Woody Allen uses original jazz soundtracks for his film, and one of his more recent films was called A Rainy Day in New York. And when I put it on, I was really pleased to hear that over the opening credits was Bing's version of I Got Lucky in the Rain, I think from a Philco show. So that's included in the medley. So we're going to finish on that tonight. Just bear with me.
Raindrops keep falling on my head, just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed. Nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops keep falling on my head, they keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun, and I said I didn't like the way he got things done. Sleeping on the job, those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. But there's one thing I know, the blues they send to meet me won't defeat me. Oh, it won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head. That doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining. Because I'm free and easy, that's my style. Free and easy, nothing's worrying me. Every time it rains, pennies from heaven. Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven? You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down. Trade them for a package of sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, you must have showers. So when you hear thunder, don't run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven for you and me. Every time it rains, pennies from heaven. And don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven? Find your fortune is falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella, you got him upside down. Trade them for a package of sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, gotta have those showers. So when you hear it thunder, don't run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven for you and me.
¿Le gustó?
Muchísimo.
Es un malo para viejo, ¿eh? Por el viejo hombre como mí.
I got lucky in the rain.
One day when I had nothing to do for an hour, I walked around in a shower. I had reason to complain. One moment I was sadly in need of a song. Next moment you came along. Then the heavens smiled at me. My heart said, how lucky can you be? Things like this you can't explain. I only know that I met the love of my life when I got lucky in the rain. Things like this you can't explain. I only know that I met the love of my life when I got lucky in the rain.
Well, 40 days or 40 nights of rain, and I didn't get as lucky as that guy, for sure.
Beautifully put together, Jason. Yep. Thank you.
Brilliant compilation.
Cool. I hope you enjoyed that. We're just about out of time. But before we
recommend Midnight in Paris.
Oh, they're all great as far as I'm concerned, Nicholas. You know, it's like, as far as I'm concerned, Bing can't do anything wrong, and neither can Woody Allen, to be honest.
Yeah, yeah.
Definitely.
Guys, before we wrap up, can we give a thank you to our presenters and presentation compilers, Robert, Bob Phillips, and Malcolm? Thanks, guys. Yep.
Thank you. Wonderful.
Wonderful presentations.
Excellent.
Cool.